Welcome to the Tennis Warehouse shoe review of the Yonex Power Cushion Fusion Rev 3. With this update, the Fusion Rev 3 continues to offer a glove-like fit and a well-cushioned ride. A full booty construction wraps the foot for secure fit, while a power graphite sheet through the midfoot adds stability by resisting unwanted twisting. Underfoot, an Endurance rubber outsole provides lasting traction in a modified herringbone tread pattern. The Fusion Rev 3 fits true to size, is slightly narrower in the midfoot, and offers a medium-height arch support. First up on today's review, we have Jason. Now, Jay, you've got a wider foot. This one's a bit of more of a narrow fitting shoe. How did that work out for you, and what was the rest of the shoe like out there on the court?
Well, performance-wise, I thought the shoe performed really well on court. I've always been a fan of the Power Cushion system, and with it, it just gives that nice, plush, comfortable ride. Like you mentioned, the fit is kind of where I had issues with it. It's a little bit too narrow for me, especially through the midfoot. I was definitely getting some arch soreness. And it took me about 7-8 hours of playtest time before I kind of broke it in, and that kind of went away. But on court, the shoe felt really stable, supportive. I was a little skeptical of the asymmetrical lacing system, but it turned out to work really well. My foot felt locked in and secure. So overall, I think if you have kind of a narrow to medium width foot, then this is a good option.
Next up, a guy who puts lots of court time on his shoes, scampering around on the baseline, Booney. How did this Fusion Rev 3 work out for you?
Wow, if I was gonna have a shoe tailored for my feet, this could be it. And I'm really happy to say that, because prior models of most of the Yonex shoes have not fit my feet that well. This one, on the other hand, really impressive shoe all the way around. I'll talk first about the midsole. I really like a low center of gravity, low to the ground profile shoe. This gives it to me. Usually that's at the expense of a little comfort and cushioning. Really surprised that the midsole gave me plenty of cushioning. I do feel low to the ground with the shoe. Ventilation was never an issue. I always take exception to the booty unitongue design. Some of them are a little easier to slip in and out of than others. This one was easy entry and exit, no problem. As Jay spoke to, the asymmetrical lacing system. At first, you know, you're just used to seeing it go straight up the middle over the bridge of the foot, but in terms of how it held my foot in place, this had to be a design thing. It really works well, and then, you know me, I ride my bike a lot to work, and it kind of keeps my chain ring clean of the laces, keeps them out of there. So not really a tennis specific thing, but just overall traction on the shoe was top notch. Like Jay said, it cradled my foot a little bit in the midfoot, but after not 7 or 8 hours, but maybe 10-15 minutes, it opened up a little bit. My foot is probably a little narrower through the middle, and therefore it kind of made the front of the shoe seem a little wider, even though it's not really a wide shoe. One of the top three playtest shoes I've had this year.
Next up, we have Troy Lara. Now, Troy, you have a narrow fit similar to me, and you also you go with the no-show socks quite often rather than the crews. How did the booty construction and the fit work out for you?
Yeah, I love the fit of this shoe. Unlike previous Yonex shoes I've play tested, I actually really had no break-in issue. Didn't have any sort of that, you know, cramping towards the mid region that I kind of got with the Eclipse 2 that we tested. So the fit was good for me. Unique thing here, the asymmetrical lacing system. At first, I hadn't really had any shoes like this, but actually thought it worked well. I didn't think it, at first, it was gonna support me all that well, because it didn't seem to go up that high on the shoe, but I really felt locked in. I think the combination of that lacing system with the booty construction felt great on my foot. And yes, with no-show socks, I had no pinching or rubbing. Usually the one common spot where I get that is the back of the ankle, the Achilles region. And these were just super plush, super comfortable in that aspect. I loved the low to the ground feel. When I'm on the balls of my feet, I felt very connected to the court, felt like I could change direction really easily. And then to match that, it wasn't too minimal where I felt like there wasn't any cushioning. There was just enough cushioning there to support me. Not as much padded plush feel as the Power Cushion Eclipsions, but there was just enough there where I didn't ever have any comfort issues underneath the forefoot. So overall, I really like this shoe. Maybe not the most durable option, but definitely something that I'd use as like a match day shoe, whereas the Eclipsion, Power Cushion Eclipsion would be more of like a all day trainer.
I was also on this shoe playtest, and I really enjoyed this shoe. It did take a little bit of a break in for me. I have a narrow foot, but I did find it a little too tight for me through the midfoot, just on the lateral edge. I was getting a little bit of biting there. But once I broke the shoe in, I felt great. It fit my foot really well, really wrapped it like a glove, and I felt like I could move around and felt very secure in the shoes. As I mentioned, the lacing system being off to the side, does take a little bit of getting used to, and I found myself tying the knot still straight up, so right on the kind of the medial edge of that lacing system. But I did like the way it supported the foot. I felt very secure on the lateral stops when I was being aggressive and changing directions. The traction offered a nice blend of grip and give. I felt like I had enough grip to sprint to the next shot. And yeah, I could also slide out of a shot if needed, just to take some stress off my ankles and knees. Also, as others mentioned, the power cushioning system is phenomenal. It really does take the sting out of those tough landings and also feels nice and responsive too. So it's you get comfort plus a nice fast response out of this one. Really enjoyed this play test. Highly recommend it if you've got a narrow foot. I think this is a great option to go with. That's all we got for this version of the shoe review. For more information on this Yonex shoe or anything else tennis related, be sure to go to Tennis Warehouse, Tennis Warehouse Europe, or Tennis Only.